Good morning, everyone. We are Rex and Chinyi.
Good morning, everyone.
Today we are having some hiccup.
In the morning.
Yes. Yeah, in the morning. No worries, but
everything settled down.
Continue our live today because we are sharing our RCCA Bryan and Jez story.
Yes.
Just tag them. Okay, so their story, they are like a young, lovely couple. And Bryan has done quite a number of
business
before. He did banana plantation.
Banana
plantation. He set up an IT company before. Morning, Vivian. Morning, Michelle.
Hair salon. Owner. Yeah.
Yes, and what else? And hair salon owner, yes. That's what he studied.
Hairdresser also.
Yeah, hairdresser. Mm. And yet, his family business is actually hardware.
Hardware, yes.
And
so he has done different. Actually, why did he want to try so many different industry?
Because at first, I think he didn't want to go back to his family business. He want to show to his parents and even his family that he can start from zero.
Yeah.
And build his own career.
Yes.
So that's why he went to study as a hairdresser. And then
he keep on looking for opportunity, I think.
Yes, and he did open up this hair salon at the point of time that when he started to gain profit.
Mm-hmm.
When he started to gain profit, the father actually call him and ask him come back home
and pass the
hardware shop key to him. Nah.
This is your shop.
So you go and close
take good
your,
care of your
you
business.
Close your hairdresser salon and come back and continue our family business. That's what happened.
So I still remember, even though you say when the hair salon start to making profit, right? It was not easy when I heard what he was sharing. Really, really not easy because
very competitive.
The price war. Then also when he was there, like in order to make more money, so he had, because he's the boss, he also the hairdresser, so morning till night he has to stand there and keep on working
and not just that, he actually if can you imagine if during this pandemic no one can open up their shops, especially service line.
Yes,
that you are going to, that's a very close human touch, that kind of job.
Yeah.
It's not easy for them to sustain.
Mm-hmm.
So then he chose to go back and help out his parents to continue with the family business. But at the same time, what happened is he, together with Jessica,
it's a wife.
She actually studied, she completed a degree.
Oh, she speaks good English and good Malay.
Yeah, and then she been a part-time model before. That's why you can see that so pretty. She's so pretty. Okay, but then because after married, Bryan asked her to become a full-time homemaker. Stay at home.
Yeah, stay home.
To take care of the children.
And I will supply everything.
Yeah. So during they have shared this before personally to us. They say actually during this period of marriage, what happened is both of them have lack of confidence, lack of communication. And both of them is like any little things, it will start quarreling.
Yeah. Because they start fighting for own stance.
Yeah.
I would say.
And both of them do not have any mutual
understanding, mutual agreement, mutual direction.
Mutual direction, should say.
Yeah.
Mutual goal in life. So that's why and even at the point of time, Jessica actually mentioned this. She said at the point of time they really wanted to
divorce.
But then luckily and very blessing that they met BE. And their mentor is our mentor also. Mentor
RCCA, Jet, and Xiaomei.
Yes. And they actually call up. Bryan received a call. And this call actually changed his life. Morning, June. Okay. And this call actually from Jet. our mentor Jed and call him and say, "Hey brother, we're going to start up our new company and this product is actually very good. You want to join us or not? Only how much? Ding, 60. Ah, that time is with GST 65.
Yeah.
So it's only minimal cash. He say,
true or not? Where got such good business?
Where got such good opportunity and business? It just requires 60 ringgit to start off the business. Aiyah, where got? Then he say, yes, believe in me. I come and look for you. And then mentor Jack came. Okay. And met. Of course, Brian has a group of good friends. Okay, they always do business together.
The buddy.
These buddies. Okay, buddy these buddies. Gang. And now the buddy gang already become CCA.
Whoa.
Wow, in Be International. And they go travel together. They achieve target together. Okay, so then all of them met mentor Jack. And all of them sign up on the spot and try the Alora pants.
And I remember this, Brian always say this when he said, he was actually very, very touched.
Yeah.
When the first time they brought the whole bus, you see, almost the whole bus that came from Mua all the way to KL to attend BOS, if I'm not wrong.
Yes.
So, at BOS there, so they met mentor, RCCA Chua Tikun. So when they sat down, right, they have to ask a lot of questions, you know, Q&A session. Then, RCCA Chua Tikun, he wrote a word to them which touched them all. Really, left them a very, very deep impression. This impression that, wow, and that word is family in Mandarin.
It's family.
Yeah, family. So they were touched like, this whole business, the core is
the core value
because of the family.
Yes.
It's not only our own family, but the whole BE family. So we are all interconnected in a family.
Yeah, and Brian actually quit school quite early and started working at hair salon for some years. Then he opened up his hair salon business at the age of 21. That's very young, right?
Yes.
And he actually say, after he closing down his saloon, he helped his father to run
the hardware business.
So he managed the business well for 10 years. But the business is getting more challenging because of the price war, just now you're saying. All that very complication. Happened in conventional business. And what amazed him. Brian, other than the family.
Morning, Tiki.
Other than the family value. He saw BE business actually integrates the online and offline platforms and doesn't require any inventory. Not like conventional business.
Oh my god.
Inventory. Wow.
He told us that, you know, in my hardware shop, one screw, one any small different size of screw, I also need to take inventory.
Yeah, so he say, wow, really headache taking all the hardware inventory.
Mm.
So, in a conventional business, it's about making small profits and quick returns and requires inventory with inflations.
Yes.
That's what make him very headache. We need more funds to keep stock. But in BE, you do not need to invest millions to expand your business internationally. Conventional business, how to do international, right? In BE International, we can expand our network through international. And all you need to do is just share. That's all. So,
just share
me. So, what happened is both of them, they actually share that her aunt was her aunt Jessica. Jessica say her aunt is very impressed that when Jessica got their first 5-figure income.
Ooh.
Yes, through the right platform and the right company. And her aunt say although she has worked as a PA for 20 years, her income had never hit 5 figures.
Wow, 20 years, man.
So they keep on emphasize one thing. Put the right effort
On the right platform.
On the right platform. Place. Yeah. So in Jessica is inexperienced, as I say, Jessica is a full-time homemaker. She's inexperienced in any work or job before.
Yes.
But now she has transformed into mompreneur.
Mompreneur.
So she say it's not difficult for a housewife to become entrepreneurs in Be International. It's only difficult when you limit yourself.
Here, it's all here.
The mindset that limits you.
Yes.
Okay, as soon as you step outside your comfort zone, you'll find a way. You'll find your way. Yeah. So Bryan admits the deep down, he always bother about people calling him the fortune son with a father to rely on. I wanted to prove that I'm just like my father and my grandfather.
Isn't that a lot of people say about you also last time?
Yeah, it's quite similar actually. But no lah, my friend don't really say that. But what Bryan wanted to prove is he want to prove that he himself is a self-made man. He can actually start from scratch and start on his own career, own business. Founder Hui Jin. Executive director and founder Ho Hui Chin once said that our parents can only give us a good background, but it's up to us to achieve our own success. Finally, I did it with BE.
Wow!
And the smile on my father's face are my greatest.
That's what we were saying about RCCA Inin as well, right?
Yes.
To bring back this pride. To make our parents proud.
Yes. And in conventional business, you can win many, many times. But one failure is like...
total collapse, right? Devastating.
Yes. But in BE, you can feel rejected. You got rejected many, 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 many times. But when success come, it'll be for a lifetime. So it's totally different story. Totally different.
Did you mention that RCCA Bryan, he also not only he never actually received high level of education.
Yes, he quit school early, but he has this difficulties in recognizing characters and words in school. So he is to learn words, to memorize any character, it's very difficult for him. He has this reading
disorder. Called dyslexia.
Reading disorder. Yeah. But
even a person like that also can become RCCA.
Yes, exactly.
Can you imagine that? So today,
never look down on yourself. Yes. Okay, you can be greater than what you think you are.
Yes.
Especially putting the right effort on the
right platform. And I recall RCCA, Sikok Seng once said, do not let your past to define your future.
Yes.
What's really, really important is right now, choose the right platform, put the right effort, and you will become successful. One success guarantee you a lifetime success.
Yes. So this is the story of RCCA Bryan and Jez.
Yes, that's right.
So signing off today.
For today.
Today is 31st of July. Oh.
So?
2021. Oh. 7 months past. Oh.
Already 7 months past. Have you achieved your dream? Yeah.
Okay. So then advertisement time.
Yes.
We will have a Zoom marathon sharing.
Oh, that's very important.
Shiroto marathon sharing. 3 p.m. later. Mandarin session. 8:30. Bahasa session. Tomorrow 3 p.m. English session.
Yes.
Okay. So see you there on air. Zoom.
Bye.
Bye. Signing off.
Signing off by Rex and Chinyi.